welcome to today's video where we will be discussing immediate innate immune responses. Video out before watching this video, as in that video I described the two main broad systems within our immune system, which are the innate immune system, which is for all non-specific responses, so to act against all diseases or pathogens, and then also the adaptive immune system, which is actually specific to certain pathogens or disease-causing agents. And so you can think of the innate immune system as a castle wall defending against all outside invaders. And you can think of the adaptive immune system as something more specific, such as a catapult, which is aimed at fighting a certain group of people. And so in today's video, I'm just going to discuss elements of the innate immune system. So our innate immune response is actually composed of two different types of the innate immunity. And so the first is the immediate innate immunity. And so this occurs 0 to 4 hours after exposure to diseases or pathogens. The second of which is the early induced innate immunity. And this happens a little bit later, from 4 to 96 hours after exposure. And for today's video, we are just going to discuss the immediate innate immune response. So within our immediate innate immune response, we have some key fighters or molecules that fight off pathogens. The first of which are called antimicrobial peptides. And so antimicrobial just means anti-microbes, so to fight microbes. And then peptides are very small protein molecules. And so proteins are made up of amino acids. And here this figure is showing a few peptide molecules. So here the different colored balls are amino acids, which are then stringed together to create short peptide molecules. And then the other really important fighter within our immediate innate immunity are complement system proteins. And a protein is basically a larger version of a peptide. So here we see a figure of a protein, and we see that there's a greater number of amino acids that are strung together. But also you'll see that there's 3D structure, and that's another important difference between proteins and peptides. And so complement system proteins are proteins that actually complement other important immune proteins and cells, such as antibodies and phagocytes. And antibodies and phagocytes are explained further in that other video that I mentioned earlier titled Elements of Immunology. And so today we're just going to talk a little bit more about antimicrobial peptides and the complement system within our immediate innate immunity. Now, looking a little bit closer at antimicrobial peptides, here I'm just going to give one example of a very common antimicrobial peptide within our body, which are defensins. And defensins are found mainly in our blood and in mucus, predominantly within our lungs. And these are short peptides of about 30 to 40 amino acids long. And they come in two main types, which are the alpha and beta defensins. And these basically have different protein structures. And so here's a figure showing the alpha defensin and the beta defensin. I won't go into them into much detail, just to keep things short for today. But broadly, what defensins do is they're very cool molecules because they are soluble, which means that they dissolve in water. And what they can then do is actually they put themselves or squeeze themselves into the membranes of microbes. And when they do this, they create a pore through the microbial membrane. And this allows water to rush into the microbe and causes it to burst and then die. So if we look at this figure here in the dark purple, we have defensins, and what they've done is they've actually squeezed themselves into the microbial membrane, which is shown here. So this is our lipid bilayer, which is what creates a membrane. And we can imagine that here at the bottom is the inside of the microbe, and here is the outside. And due to physics, we'd have higher water pressure here. And so it rushes into our microbe and then bursts it or kills it. And going on to the complement system now. So the complement system within our immediate innate immune response is made up of special proteins called enzymes. And enzymes are proteins which are really important for chemical reactions in the body. So they basically speed up chemical reactions. And what these complement system enzymes do is they basically just patrol your body. So they're going through your blood system and they're on the lookout for pathogens. And what happens is when they find a pathogen or a disease-causing agent, when that is detected in the body, these enzymes then trigger what's called an enzyme cascade. And so this enzyme cascade basically means that the few enzymes that start this reaction then signal to the other enzymes near it, which then signal to the enzymes near those enzymes, which creates a really amplified response. And this is really important so that all the other important fighters within our immune system are able to come to the area where pathogens are and easily destroy the pathogens before they're able to spread throughout their body. So you can think of an enzyme cascade as, say, the first enzyme starts a domino response, and you can see this here in the graph. So if we look at the number of enzymes that are triggered throughout time, so at first we just have a few enzymes that are triggered, and then this would exponentially grow as more and more enzymes are part of this cascade. So that's it for today's video. I hope that you enjoyed it and you found it helpful. If you did enjoy this video, please subscribe for more. Thanks.